Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if you are new, hello, I am Simphora, or also known as Izzy. And here on my YouTube channel, I make Sims content. For today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I get The Sims 3 gameplay and environment to look more aesthetically appealing. Not trying to bring down The Sims 3, but I have to say that the game looks very dull graphic-wise. So I'm gonna be showing you all how to make the game look more realistic, vibrant, have contrast, and the perfect tone of brightness, just with a few mods and reshades. So the first lightning mod that I will be introducing you all to is the lightning mod that you guys seen in my intro, and it's called Frozen Inspired Light Mod, created by Burnt Waffles. This lightning mod has to be my all-time favorite because I used to use another lightning mod also created by Burnt Waffles, but it wasn't hitting the same as this one does. However, I'm gonna put my old lightning mod that I used to use in the description box down below for anyone that wants to check it out, but just make sure that you're only using one lightning mod at a time or it will not work at all. This lightning mod features bright Disney-esque colors, new auroras, 5 different possible sunset and sunrises that includes pink, orange, or red ones that will appear, cotton ball clouds appear in the non-aurora version, longer days, DD Fender dynamic shadows includes sun aura, and less bloom. Now what you're gonna do is read these options and choose one to download from. I am currently using With Aurora and Isla Paradiso water because I love looking at the aurora at night, and Islands Paradise came with light bright blue water that looks beautiful. I really want to show you guys 2 more lightning mods that I obviously used to use before I found Frozen Inspired, because it took me a while to find the perfect lightning mod for myself, and I also recommend checking out these other lightning mods if the one that I am currently using isn't aesthetically appealing to yourself. This next lightning mod is called Uranesia Lightning Mod Plus, created by Neilsys. This lightning mod is so pretty. It comes with 11 new versions that feature some cool new additions like non-green sunrises, 2 new watercolors, and brighter night. One thing about this mod that you all should know is that it doesn't include custom clouds. You can get custom clouds, but I'll talk more about that later on. The last lightning mod that I will be showing is called Mediterranean Day. This was my very first lightning mod I've ever discovered when I started getting into mods. I think I used to use this mod back in my Toshiba laptop days, so if you know, you know. This lightning mod consists of sunny blue skies, white clouds when the weather is set to partly cloudy, a more saturated sea color, and pink and orange sunsets. Overall, this is another great lightning mod. It's just more settling to the eyes without being too bright and vibrant. Now we're gonna move on to the sky and how to get realistic clouds. So this is yet another wonderful mod created by Neilsys. It's called Realistic Clouds. I love this mod so much. It's a game changer because the clouds that EA gave us was a big no for me. And you guys know I love a realistic gameplay. The good thing about this mod is that it's compatible with all lightning mods as long as it doesn't include other custom clouds. Also, you might need to enable advanced rendering if the clouds don't appear. I already have mine enabled. The next sky mod is called Milky Way Night Sky. I actually just found this mod as I was lurking through this Tumblr page, and I'm definitely going to give this mod a try because look how realistic the night sky can be. I think the stars are really doing it for me because EA barely gave us any stars. This mod replaces the original star field, adding a view of the Milky Way to the night sky of your game, and it's compatible with any lightning mod that doesn't include a replacement of the star field. Alright, now we're getting into the minor detailed environment mods for The Sims. This mod is called Snow But Better, created by Lyra Lay. It's basically a snow replacement mod. If you look at the comparison images, this mod has more texture to the snow than what EA has given us. The snow on the road looks way better, the icicles look more realistic, and the snow on the windows look less foggy and blurry. Last but not least, this mod is called Improved Environmental Shadows, created by SimC45. This mod enhances the graphics so well with a little bit of sharpness and darker shadows. It's so realistic. You have the option to choose between darker shadows or dynamic shadows. I am currently using the dynamic shadows because the darker shadows is too dark for my liking. Just a little disclaimer, both of these files conflict with lighting mods, so make sure you guys read which one you're going to download and delete any resources that this mod may conflict with so it can actually work. The moment you've all been waiting for, reshade presets. This is another way to make your game look aesthetically appealing. Reshade presets are lifesavers, and I feel like reshades are the reason as to why my game looks brighter and vibrant. The reshade that I am currently using is called Daydream by Irrisabled Dinosaur. This reshade preset is bomb. However, I want to say that reshades should typically be used for taking pictures and not used for gameplay because reshades are super heavy, but this preshade has hasn't made my game lag or crash once is probably because I have a high-end gaming computer, so definitely use reshaders at your own risk. Also, I'm gonna be nice and show you guys how to download reshades because it's a question I get all the time and the installation process can be confusing. Now onto the tutorial. The first thing you wanna do is go on the website called ReShadeMe and scroll all the way to the bottom and download the most recent reshade version. Once the ReShade application is downloaded onto your computer, you're gonna click select a game. I already have mine installed, but I will still guide you guys through this entire process. So once you click that, you're probably not gonna see The Sims 3 pop up in this little box here. So you're gonna click browse, just waiting for it to load. All right, now you're gonna go into your local disk and go to program files times 86. Now I play The Sims 3 on Origin, so I don't know if it might be different for you guys if you play on Steam. So Origin Games, The Sims 3, you're gonna go to Game, Bin, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna click open on ts3.exe. Just like that. Now you're gonna see which rendering API does The Sims 3 use. The Sims 3 only uses Direct 3D9, so don't click anything else. Once you click it, I'm going to press update because I don't wanna uninstall it. And you're gonna see all these effect packages to install. I didn't click anything, but just okay. And there you go, it is in your game. Well, not yet. And then you're gonna have some more things to install. Click okay. And there you go. Once the ReShade application gets installed successfully in The Sims 3, you can finally download the ReShade preset that you want. You just need to place it in the bin folder. I'll do another rundown on how to get into the bin folder. Basically, you need to go to your local disk, program files times 86, Origin Games, The Sims 3, Game, and then Bin. The Sims 3 is now open, and I'm not gonna leave you guys in the dust because in order for you to actually enable the ReShade in game, you need to see this black box in the left corner. For this black box to show up, you need to press the home key on your keyboard and look all the way at the top and choose your ReShade that you installed. As you can see, mine is Daydream. The extra stuff that you guys see with the check marks are the effects that we installed. You can play around with them to adjust the ReShade to your own liking. If you wanna take pictures with the ReShade, all you have to do is press the hotkeys F9 or F8 on your keyboard and then press print on your keyboard to take the picture. Do not press C because then you won't be able to see the ReShade in your picture. The picture will then be in your bin folder. Anyways, I'm gonna end this video right here. I hope this video helped you guys because I know you've been all waiting for this video. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you're new, and I will see you all in my next video.